Hello students, this is Shweta Roy. This video is for Chapter 1, Economics, Part 1. The Story of Village Palampur. In this video, we are going to discuss about a village of Palampur and the basic concept which we are going to understand in this chapter is the production. So, the purpose of the story is to introduce some of the basic concept which is related to production. And like this, we can go through the story of a hypothetical village which is called Palampur. Now, farming is the main activity of this village. And several other activities are also done, like small scale manufacturing, dairy, transport, etc. So with farming is the main activity, and with farming there are several other activities which is going on in this village Palampur. These production activities need various type of resources, like natural resources, man-made items. It also need human effort, it needs money, etc. So these kind of various resources are needed for the activities which is going on. Now, by learning the story of reading the story of Palampur, we will learn that how various resources combine together to produce the desired good and services in the village. So here we will start with the introduction of the story. So this Palampur village is a well connected village, and it is properly connected with the neighboring villages and towns. And there is a Raiganj, which is a very big village, which is near 3 kilometers, which is about 3 kilometers from Palampur. Now, all wither road connects the village to Raiganj and further on to the nearest small town of Shahpur. And many kinds of transports are visible on the road, like bullock carts, tangas, bogies. Bogies is actually the wooden cart which is drawn by the buffalo. You can see in the picture. So that is bogies, which is loaded with jaggery. Also other commodities to motor vehicles like motorcycles, jeeps, tractors and trucks. So these motor vehicles can also be seen on the road. Now the village has about 450 families which belongs to different castes. There are many different castes in that 450 families. Now 80 upper caste families have majority of the land in the village. The land which is there are of the upper caste families, which are 80 in number, and they have majority of land. Their houses, some of them quite large and are made of brick with cement plastering. So you can see they have pakka house. And the SCs, which are actually Dalits, they comprise 1/3 of the population and live in one corner of the village. And and in very small houses. So some of are of mud and straw. So here you can see Palampur is a village of 450 families. In that, many different castes are there. It is well connected with the neighboring villages and towns. That means transportation system is there. And the near a big village is near to it, 3 kilometers away from Palampur, that is Raiganj. That is a big village. Also, there is Shahpur, which is a small town, which is near to it. And many kinds of transports are available, bullock carts, tongas, bogies, motor vehicles like motorcycles, jeeps, tractors and trucks. So it is a good village. And like other villages, majority of the land of the village are with 80 upper caste families. And the Dalits, SCs, they are 1/3 of the population and they are given the corner of the village. They live in the corner of the village. When we see the difference in the house, SC's house is of is smaller and made of mud and straw. The upper caste families, they have good pakka house. Some are quite large and some are made of brick and cement plastering. Also, some of the houses have electric connections. Now, this electricity powers all the tube wells in the field and also used for the small businesses. There are 2 primary school and 1 high school in the village. There is a primary health center which is run by government. And 1 private dispensary is there where the sick are treated. So there are 2 primary schools, 1 high school, 1 health center, primary health center of government, 1 private dispensary. Now this is the description. And this description shows that Palampur has a fairly well developed system of roads, transport, electricity, irrigation, schools and health center. Now you need to compare these facilities with those in your nearby village. So this is an activity. Compare these facilities with the facility which you have near by village or in your own village. You can compare it with your own village also. So make a report for this. Now the story of this Palampur, which is an Palampur is an imaginary village. This will take us to different types of production activities in the village. Which kind of production is going on in the village? Now, if we talk about the villages across India, farming is the main production activity. And the other activity means non-farming activities like small manufacturing, transport, shopkeeping, etc. These kind of small manufacturer activities. That means non-farming activities. So you can see there are farming activities and non-farming activities. So we shall take a look at both these types of activities after learning about few general things about the production. So organization of production. Now here, what is the aim of production is to be? So the aim of production is to produce the goods and services that we want. There are 4 requirements for the production of goods and services. The first requirement is land. and other natural resources like water, forests, minerals. Now, the second requirement for production is labor, and that is the people. The people who will do the work, that is labor, and that is the second requirement of the production. Now, some of the production activities require highly educated workers, while other activities require the workers who can do manual work. So, some activities require high skilled labor, high educated workers, and some require manual workers. And each worker is providing the labor necessary for the production. Now, the third requirement is physical capital. That is variety of inputs required at every stage during production. Now, what are the items that come under physical capital? So, tools, machines, and buildings. These things come under the physical capital. Now, these tools and machines can be very simple tools like a farmer's plough, which is very simple, and it can be sophisticated machines also, like generator, turbines, computers. So these comes in the physical capitals, and these tools, machines, and buildings can be used in production over many years. We can use this for many years. It is not we can use once. So these are called fixed capital. Now, second is raw materials and money in hand. So the production requires variety of raw materials like yarn. Yarn is used by the weavers. Clay is needed. Clay is used by potters. Also, some money is required for every production, because you need to do the payments. You need to buy the things, buy the raw materials. So you need to do the payments, and thus you need some of the money. Now, raw materials and money in hand are called working capital. So you can see tool, machines, buildings are fixed capitals because they are long lasting. They are doing production for many years, so they are fixed capitals. Raw materials and money can be used that time, that is working capital. Now, unlike tool, materials, and buildings, these are used up in the production. These cannot be kept for many years or a long time. They will be used that time only. So that this is called working capital. Now, there is fourth requirement, that is you need knowledge and enterprise to be able to put together land, labor, and physical capital and produce an output either to use yourself or to sell in the market. And this is called human resources. So this is called human capital. So about human capital, we will discuss more in our next chapter. Here you have a picture. This is the picture of a factory. And here you can see several laborers and machines. Now you need to identify the land, labor, and fixed capital which is used in the production. So do this activity. Now, every production is organized by combining this land, labor, physical capital and human capital. By all these four resources, we need to combine these four resources and then there will be a production. And this is known as the factors of production. This land, labor, physical capital and human capital are known as factors of production. Now, when we will go through this story, we will understand more about the first three factors of the production. And physical capital is referred as capital in the chapter. So, wherever the word capital is used, understand that is physical capital. If we go to the conclusion of this video, we had introduction of the chapter. So according to that, the Palampur is fairly connected with a well-developed system of roads, transport, electricity, irrigation, schools and health centers. The story of Palampur takes us through the different types of production activities in the village. In India, farming is main production activity across villages. Organization of production. The main aim of production is to produce goods and services which require four essential things: land and other natural resources such as water, forests, minerals, labor, physical capital such as tools, machines, buildings, raw materials and money. A variety of raw materials are required while production, such as the yarn used by the weaver and clay used by the potter. Money is also essential during production, and both of them in hand are called working capital. The fourth requirement is knowledge and enterprise to be able to put together land, labor and physical capital and produce an output. Now, factors of production are combining of land, labor, physical capital and human capital. So this is the conclusion of the video. I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.